Well, that's Jonathan Perez. The theme of Popeye rings true there, as you can see. He's from Colombia. 33 wins, 10 losses. His first fight in the U.S. since 2011. He's been KO'd or stopped 8 times. Told us yesterday that he's been working much better recently on transferring his weight and creating more power. And he better, because he's up against a guy that is spilling over with confidence, and that is 19-0, 24-year-old Luis Rosa, who took a 40-minute drive up I-91. He comes from New Haven, Connecticut. He's trained by his father, who runs the Boxing and Faith Gym, managed by a local businessman, Mike Crisio. And Rose is a very likable young prospect. 5'5", 123.5 pounds for Rosa. Teddy, let's see what the fighters need to do to look like a champ, and that's brought to you by Just For Men.
For Luis Rosa, go forward and go to that body. And for Jonathan Perez, cattle on the outside, because he's going to be coming forward. It makes sense.
Here, the nice reception for Connecticut's own Rosa here.
Nine of them coming by way of knockout. From New Haven, Connecticut, ladies and gentlemen, Luis K.O. King Rosa. Rosa.
Already his third fight of 2015. Had 2 quick KOs prior to this. And once again, Mike Ortega gets the duties as the third man inside the rope. Scheduled for 8.
They give me a good clean fight. I'm going to play a win limpia. Good luck to both of you. Buena suerte a los dos. Touch them up.
Well, Perez was knocked out in his last fight. I can tell you, not a good way to go into a fight with an undefeated prospect.
Len, you all set?
Most of Perez's fights, Joe, have been in Colombia. How important is it where you get your fights?
Oh, very, in a case like Colombia, right?
Yeah, I'll tell you exactly how important it is. Perez is 32-0 in his home country of Colombia, and 1-10 outside of Colombia, and knocked out 8 times.
Enough said there, right?
Enough said.
He was unbeaten in 14 straight fights prior to his last fight and loss, when he was TKO'd by Horacio Garcia in Mexico. Obviously, the 14 previous fights, he was feasting on limited competition back home in Colombia.
Now, I must say, Rosa, maybe not a monster. He was on the floor in his last fight with a 17-15 opponent. Not a monster, maybe. Rosa has been penalized for low blows. For me, Joe, after all we've said already, if Rose is to be taken seriously as a prospect, you know, to keep an eye on, then he probably should knock out Perez, since, as we said, he's been knocked out 8 times. And also, in his last fight, he was knocked out by an undefeated prospect.
And he acknowledged that when we talked to him, and he understands what Perez is and what Perez isn't. So let's see if he can now act on it and execute that plan. Goes to the body there, good combination. Uppercut in the mix with the right hand from Rosa. And Perez utilizing that jab.
Rosa likes to go to the body. He should start doing it. He likes to switch once in a while, Rosa. Hasn't had a reason to yet, to lefty, you know, southpaw once in a while. You'd like to see Perez use his legs a little bit. Rosa's a square-footed guy. Needs to be set to do this to work. And now Rosa turns southpaw for a second. So you'd like to see Perez use his legs, keep Rosa a little off balance, since he is square with his feet. Easy to keep those kind of guys off balance with a little movement, little angles. Also, you'd like to see Perez use that length. He's a little longer. In other words, work the jab.
Try to get around the guard with that right hand. Now back to the jab from Perez. Reached in with a right hand, well off the mark with a left hook.
Perez has one thing going for him, Joe.
What's that?
Well, he's fought a much better opposition, even though he has lost to all of it. He's been in with it.
Perez and Rosa here at the end of one. Let's check in with Bernardo.
Thank you, and we're with Curtis Jackson, also known as 50 Cent, who's our promoter tonight. Talk to me about the development of your promotional career.
It's exciting, man. You know, it's really a reflection of my relationship with Floyd initially, and then it moved on to this. So I'm excited. It's a lot of fun for me. At the same time, I live vicariously through the fighters that I have relationships with. And it's cool to bring new energy and just the sport of boxing back to Hartford.
Talk to me about the relationship with Floyd. We saw you guys kind of get back together. How'd that happen?
Well, I always said we had like a brother's relationship. You know what I mean? So we go through our issues. Like, I got off the phone with him this morning. He'll call because he want me to see what he's actually doing at the time. And it's not, if any other situation, if a person commits to being a partner financially in a business, you sue him if they don't. I didn't sue him because I feel like he's my brother the same way. But I can't curse him out, though, if he's my brother. Don't I keep the right to curse him out if you do that to me?
You do. And we look forward to seeing you in the movie Southpaw coming up.
Always nice to visit with Curtis. I've said this before, I'll say it again, Teddy. There are a lot of guys with a lot of money who have come into boxing, invested their money in boxing. He truly has a sincere passion, a real connectivity with the sport.
Yeah, I'll tell you.
He's just not throwing the money. Obviously, he's throwing a lot of money around. Yeah. But it means something to him.
Listen, I'll say two things to that. One, I said it last week a little bit. Actually, we kind of got on the same subject. That he has thrown a lot of money to it, but in some wrong directions. He needs to get somebody involved with him that understands talent, understands what talent to invest in. Because you'd hate to see a guy like him who does have a passion for the sport, does have the means, the resources to help fighters in the sport, wind up disappearing from the sport.
Right, you don't want to get stumped.
Yeah, because he is getting stumped. And you'd hate to see him get lost where fighters could benefit from him being around and the sport could benefit from him being around. Yeah, so you'd like to see him get, you know, make his decisions and help, have somebody help him make better decisions where he puts his money and his resources. But having said
that's
that,
straight, just a little low for Rosa there. And Perez is going to take a knee. And Ortega's going to give him the 5 minutes to prepare himself to fight again.
Yeah, when you've been around 10 years like Perez and you've had 44 fights, you know how to kind of buy a little time.
Got him low.
He's going to buy a little time now.
Take a look at the low blow.
Yeah, that's not in the groin area, to be quite frank. That's more on the side, you know, on the side near the hip. But it doesn't mean it can't affect him. And maybe it did affect him, and maybe he just wanted to take a break. Either way, here we are.
The right hand from Perez that was timed well that time against the unbeaten Rosa. Both men open up on the inside. Swinging right hand simultaneously.
Now Rosa has turned southpaw. I mentioned that he can switch. Well, he figures this was the time to switch, and he has.
Squared up on the inside now after being in that southpaw stance.
Yeah, you want to see Rosa, I think, shorter, stockier, more bullish. You want to see him working on the inside. And he's really allowing Perez to outwork him right here. And catch him
right
in.
And now here's Rosa coming in after he connects on the inside. There's a short right hand in the midst there. Left hand was blocked there. Tries to go to the body. Does so with a left hand and a right hand that split the middle.
If Rosa does a bad job on the inside of keeping balance, he lets his legs get stiff. Take a look. I don't know if our cameraman will grab that. But the next time he's on the inside, take a look at Rosa's knees. They get stiff. Should be a little bend, a little flex in there so he can keep his balance. Your knees are stiff. You have no balance. That means you're actually leaning on Perez to keep your balance. That's not good. And that's why Rose is not inside right now, because he had no balance inside. And he needs to be inside, Rosa, to to really dominate this fight.
Jonathan Perez from Colombia, veteran who's taken his licks when he's been outside of his home country, going up against the undefeated fighter from right here in Connecticut, New Haven's Luis Rosa, who's 19-0. Scheduled 8-round co-feature from here at Hartford tonight. Round 3 scheduled for 8.
That's where Rosa wants to attack the body. He's built for that, Joe.
Yeah, he just has that frame.
And he's staying southpaw right now, feels comfortable with it. Watch him when he gets inside, he should stay there. And watch if his knees get stiff. If they get stiff, no balance. If they stay bent, balance. This is interesting right now because Rose is trying to get in, Perez trying to nail him on the way in.
Good action here in the opening minute of round 3.
Yeah, Perez figures that Rosa, he knows where Rosa wants to get. Right there, inside, close to him. But Perez's attitude needs to be okay. To get there, he's got to go through a bad neighborhood, as I often say. So I'm going to make sure I try to do a few bad things to him before he gets to that neighborhood.
Back to orthodox now for Rosa.
In other words, mug him on the way in. For me, Perez should be doing that. Using his jab, controlling the outside, and looking for opportunities for Rosa to give him offensive opportunities by coming straight in like that. That's where Perez needs to counter, not just make a miss.
No, no, right, right, right. Push him down. Stay off the back of his neck. Let's go.
For me, the jab should be working right now for Perez, and then he should just be waiting for that, waiting for a launch by Rosa. And when Rosa jumps in, and he will jump in, and he will leave himself open. Fill the hole, kind of like what Willie Monroe has to do. I was talking about with Todd. Willie Monroe has to do tomorrow night if he's going to beat Golovkin. Control range and make Golovkin pay for real estate when he tries to get close.
Saw the CompuBox numbers tallying the jabs there.
That's what Perez needs to do. Control the outside.
That's what he's trying to do right now. There's that double jab.
There's that jump in again by Rosa, but Perez didn't make him pay a price.
Didn't fire off anything.
Gotta make him pay when he...
See, there it is again.
Gotta make him pay when he does that.
Nothing's fired off. Instead, he puts the guard up and retreats.
And he probably wins the round this way.
That was another left hand that was right on the belt line. It was pushing down on the head, so no knockdown there.
He's pushing him down. Let's go.
That time, Perez looked to nail him coming in. Interesting fight here, Joe.
No doubt. Been entertaining. End of 3. Joe and Teddy, Todd and Bernardo with you here at the Connecticut Convention Center for the second to last Friday night fights. This series that has spanned over 17 years. There's been a lot of made and written about the end of Friday night fights, but the beginning of what will be a new ESPN boxing series starting this summer. But the weekly show goes away after next week's broadcast of Friday Night Fights.
Very bittersweet.
It is.
Now I want to mention, but I'll wait because there's a lot of action going on right here.
Good stuff between Perez and Rosa. Once again, that left hand coming close to string, just a bit low.
Yeah, once again, it's Rosa. It's all about Rosa getting in and Perez keeping him out and hurting him or trying to hurt him while he comes in. For me, Perez shouldn't be going forward. Should be jabbing to keep Rosa from going forward, and then he should be ready to pitch something, to throw something when Rosa comes in. Because Rosa comes in wide. Even here,
there's
on the
a right
inside.
Hand by Perez.
Exactly.
Between punches.
Even on the inside, even though that's Rose's territory.
He's there now.
Yeah, that's his territory.
Once again, pushing down.
Yep. Even though that's Rose's territory on the inside, Joe, Perez can do a little work in spots there because his punch is a little straighter and Rose's around. So Perez can get inside those shots on the inside. Even though at the end of the day, he shouldn't be there too long. Rose is just stronger than him on the inside. Rosa turns southpaw again. See, Rosa needs to keep those hands free when he does get in there. Again, that's his territory, his turf. Like right now, he needs to, needs not to get tied up, not to get smothered. And that means he needs to think a little bit, anticipate a little bit. Do what he just did a minute ago. Take a little step back. Man, keep the throw going.
Squared up and taking half steps forward, getting work done on the inside.
Exactly, Joe. So now he's got a good rhythm going, Rose. He's using his head and his legs.
One point. You hit him when he was down, all right? Watch that.
So a one-point deduction.
Cabeza arriba.
Doled out.
Wow. Rose had better win this round. Otherwise, there's a 10-8 round. And he knows it. And
yes,
he's acting that way.
Trying to make up for that point deduction. Good, steady stream of effort. Offensive surge from Luis Rosa. Uppercut did damage there as he fights just slightly through the bell. Well, the point deduction may have been the worst thing to happen to Perez. Doled out against Rosa, and then Rosa got after it to make up for it against Perez.
Yes, again, yeah. Hey. Agarró un gancho. Vamos, Jonathan. Tienes que, por el amor de tus hijos, ellos te quieren agarrar el cuerpo, Jonathan. God bless you, we're telling you.
This is what happened there in the fourth round.
Yeah, good call by the referee. I mean, and here's the end of the round. Just going to work. Using that uppercut. Why? Well, it makes sense. Perez leaning forward.
You saw him have a punch on the belt line. Perez took a knee, and then Rosa hit him while he was down. Just a
good job by
grazing blow. And Mike Ortega, veteran guy who takes control of situations. And the point deduction there, and then the late rally by Luis Rosa.
There are things that are more dangerous than other things in that ring. And hitting somebody when he's on his knees, that's more dangerous. And that's where you have to act immediately. Certain things you can let him go a little bit, but not things like that. Just ask Andre Durrell, who got knocked out by Arthur Abraham. He was winning the fight easily. He was on the, had a knee on the floor during the fight, and what happens? Arthur Abraham nails him, knocks him out, and Durrell was out of boxing for about 2 years. Almost destroyed his career. Happy to say Durrell persevered. He's back. It could have been much different, though. See, now I think Rosa needs to control his aggression. When he comes close, expect Perez to lean a little bit, to react to that pressure.
There's a rare 9-9 round. So Rosa wins the fourth round on Teddy's scorecard, but the point deduction makes it a 9-9 round. Viewers at home have it 3-1 for the unbeaten Luis Rosa. A reminder, you can go to ESPNvote.com/FNF or, of course, the Friday Night Fight Facebook page to vote, score along with Teddy.
See, this is where Rosa's very effective, and he's very vulnerable. People say, what do you mean, Ted? Oh, he's very effective. He's short, he's stocky. He's working where he wants to work, to the body of Perez. He's stronger than Perez, but he throws wide shots. Always a chance Perez can throw something in between.
Let's Rosa get to the inside, where Rosa's more than happy to let those hands go. Perez off balance, chase to the other corner.
So this
Rosa where, keeps on the attack.
If Rosa wants to score a knockout, this is where he, again, He has to have a memory. He has to remember how Perez has reacted when he gets him on the ropes. He leans forward. He's going to lean forward again. And he has to use that uppercut and sometimes take a half step back.
He's sitting there waiting for him right now. Ortega's taking a look. This fight could be over at any moment as Rosa is just battering Perez. He's going to let it go for a moment. Undefeated Luis Rosa will stay that way. 10th knockout of his career. He does it here in his home state.
Well, we said Rosa should knock him out if he wants to be taken seriously, and he knocked him out.
Young man is trained by his father, Luis Rosa, and as we said, now 9 times Perez has been KO'd or TKO'd. Steps outside of Colombia and steps up, and you get the same script every single time. Luis Rosa, 24-year-old from New Haven, with a good crowd of locals here to see him fight in downtown Hartford, comes up with another knockout win. Let's go back and show you the end of the fight. Stoppage, Teddy.
Yeah, you know, good referee again. You know, he started to jump in. He was, most important thing, he was aware, he was alert, he was close. He knew what was coming. He started to jump in, and then he said, all right, those punches missed just then. Let me give him another second, but I'll stay close, and I'll be ready to stop it as I was a moment ago, and then he did. So good job.
CompuBox tallied up 79 power punches landed by Luis Rosa over the last 2 rounds alone. Let's go up to the ring and get the particulars with David Diamante.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Michael Ortega calls a halt to this contest. The official time of the stoppage, 2:29 of round number 5. Your winner by TKO from New Haven, Connecticut, Luis KO King Rosa.
See more of Rosa as his career advances. Rosa now 20-0. More Friday night fights, including our main event, when we return.